If you're familiar with the channel, you're familiar with my 1980 Sears Sea Nymph. I bought this boat many years ago for $500 when I didn't have any money. It's a 16-foot boat. I absolutely love it. Floats, doesn't leak, all that good stuff. But the trailer that I have it on, or I've had it on for all these years, isn't for a 16-foot boat. It might be for like a 12, maybe 14-foot boat stretching it. It's been jimmy-rigged from there to there many years ago when I was young and dumb. Mainly because I never had the money to afford a new trailer. But I just got one. Just picked up this bad boy yesterday. I ordered it 3 months ago, thanks COVID. And it's a 16-foot trailer. Well, a trailer for a 16-foot Jon boat made by Load Right. Awesome trailer. Now, today's goal is to get that boat onto this trailer. And in my head, I was like, there's about three ways of doing this. Maybe four. Number one, take the boat in the trailer, throw it in the water, come and get this trailer, pull it up onto the new trailer. Option number two, get a bunch of buddies over here, pick up the boat. It's a Jon boat, it's not that heavy. Pick it up, throw it on the trailer. But I don't like inconveniencing other people. So I'm gonna attempt to do this all by myself. And I figure there's two options. Option number one, hook up the old trailer to the truck, back off the boat onto the ground, pick up the new trailer, hook that to the truck, then drag the boat onto the new trailer. My next option, which is what I'm gonna do, hook up the new trailer to the truck, put the old trailer behind it, unbolt the winch, and take the winch from this boat with the boat back there and just winch it all the way onto the new trailer. I think it's gonna work. It should be fun. And I'm gonna do it by myself. This is how you transfer a boat from one trailer to another trailer on land by yourself. Well, this is what we're left with. Let me chock these wheels. Safety first. Now we gotta take off the winch. Right, leave some pressure here. Take off that. That.
Gotcha. Now we gotta drop this wheel out of the way. Get down on the wood. And now we should be able to clear everything. Oh, one more thing.
Don't want to rip off my transducer. Fold that up.
Little boy. Yeah, there you go. Now the fun part.
And this is why I stopped. My bunks need to be adjusted inward just a little bit.
Better. All right, let me bolt them back down. We'll try this again.
She was just going on a little crookedy. Well, she was tipping because I didn't know where to have my winch for this boat. So I brought it down from the top and now I need to bring it back up. So this touches here. It's hot out today. Little chin music. I'm not gonna clamp it all the way until I make sure I'm in the right spot.
Well,
Well, you survived, that's good. But I think I also have my tipping issue because I have my bunks kind of close together. So off video, I'm gonna take the bunks and move them to the outside of the boat and make that a little wider.
And that's much more stable. You always want your bunks to overhang your boat just by a little bit, or you'll end up denting this here up. This corner is way more stronger than the bottom of your boat. And Bob's your uncle. We got a 1980 boat on a 2022 trailer. Now I'm more confident in taking this thing longer distances to go catch some fish, go crabbing, go on vacation, all that fun stuff. It is doable by yourself. Didn't ask for anybody's help, did everything all by myself, even recorded it for you guys. I'm a little cotton mouth because it's 150 degrees out here. I'm gonna go inside. You guys have a nice, cool, relaxing day. We'll see you next time. God bless.
Got a trailer for sale, practically brand new, used just twice.